it's a place of awe when you talk about geologic time. We're talking about looking so far back in time, it's hard to think about it. When you think about the Triassic period and the Chinle formation where these soils originated, you're looking so far back in time, it's kind of a little bit awe-inspiring. Kind of gives perspective about how little we actually have impact, you know, on our own, and how important the history of the planet is, how it's changed, developed, and continues to change over time. It provides beautiful scenic beauty. It provides some quiet, solitude, and it's a good place to feel one's place in the planet. In the late 19th century into early 20th century, there was a train stop north of here at a little place called Adamana. People got off and got on wagons and rode over to where the petrified wood was. And they put some of this on their wagon and went back to the train stop and took it home. So that's what initiated wanting to preserve some of this so it didn't all go away. And when it was originally set up, it was set up as a monument. It took some years before it became actually a national park. But it came into the park system early. 1906, Theodore Roosevelt was president at that time, and he was starting to realize that we needed to preserve some of this stuff. We're in what's called cold desert. So on this cold desert, we're going to step back and talk about geologic time, because a lot of these soils were laid down during that Triassic period. And that's where the tree-like structures that were deposited, that's when they were deposited and been laying in wait for millions of years. During that period of time, it was Pangea. There's no flowering plants and no grasses that were growing at that time either. There were some fern-like structures and these large tree-like structures. And so events, or, you know, just age or whatever, but some of them got knocked down, flowed into sediment, and covered over usually pretty quickly. And sitting there for all that time is when the mineralization process took place. The initial part of it can take tens to hundreds of years, but the thing to make it into the quartz-like structure that we see, that we call petrified wood today, took millions of years. Anytime you see red in the soil or in these logs, it's iron that's been oxidized. So what you see is no longer a tree. Never, you know, all that material is gone by the continents moving and uplifting and things weathering, so on and so forth. These soils have become exposed again, but they're exposed to a different environment, and with the rains and wind and stuff that works on this stuff, it continues to erode, which gives us these beautiful bands of color of soils and these wonderful shapes that, even during the course of a day, to look at them in the morning and then look at them in the afternoon, you get two different perspectives. The deal is though, with those highly erodible soils and those different layers we're looking at, were laid down, like I say, over millions of years, a period of time from about 202 to 227 million years ago during the Triassic period. Well, there were dinosaurs here, but there are other animals that were alive also. All this stuff was buried for millions and millions and millions of years. They still discover new species here as they work out here. More of the fossil record continues to get filled in by what they do find here. It helps them figure out the lineage of how things did evolve over time. It's just part of a natural part of history that's not prevalent very much in the world at all. There are other places where petrified wood is, but this one, with the environment here and everything else, is unique in that there's a large display of it, easily accessible. You have to come out here, see it, and experience it. Then you get a feel for what you're looking at, what this is about. You can look at pictures, you can talk about it, but until you come out here and experience this, get a feel for it. The vastness, the colors, the texture, shapes, how quiet it is. I mean, this is an incredible place.